If you're looking to create a slideshow, documentary, or really any video that contains still images, one of the most effective ways to bring your photos to life is to add what we refer to as the Ken Burns effect. Today, using Final Cut Pro, I'm going to teach all of you at home how to master this effect, including how to add multiple camera movements. That's all coming up next on Tech Talk America. Hello everyone and welcome to the class. Today we are going to be talking all about the Ken Burns effect. And even though this video is technically all about editing, the Ken Burns technique is really about how to use this effect in order to tell a story. And if this video helps you tell your story, I hope you'll let me know about it. Leave me a comment down below, hit the like button, and if you haven't already done so, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and be sure to hit the little bell for notifications. You've probably seen the Ken Burns effect a million times in various wedding videos, slideshows that are played at family reunions, graduations, funerals, bar mitzvahs, etc. Before we go over how to achieve this effect, I first want to show you a quick pointer that I hope may help you organize your photos. That way, when it comes time to edit, you already have them all good to go. Then I'll show you the basic method of how to achieve the Ken Burns effect. And finally, I'll show you how to add those multiple camera movements. At this point, let's switch over to my Mac. The first place to start when you want to make a video slideshow is to organize your photos into an album. So before this class, I went into the Photos app and created a new album called Awkward Childhood. That way, it'll be very easy to find when I open up Final Cut Pro. So once you have your photos all organized into an album, you can open up Final Cut and create a brand new project. When you're establishing your settings for this new project, make sure that you consider the resolution of the photos that you're going to be working with. For example, if the photos that you're using are lower resolution, when you consider the fact that we're going to be zooming into those photos, you might want to consider changing the resolution of your project to 1080p, which will still look pretty good and will make the final file size a bit more mobile friendly. Now, let's go into the photo browser here at the top left, and let's change the location to My Albums. After that, you can see that my album of awkward childhood photos has appeared here at the top. Before we go dragging these photos into the timeline, keep in mind that you may want to first double-check your image duration preferences. This is basically how long the shot will be just by default. And while you can change the length, of course, at any point later on, if you have your image duration preferences closer to what you actually want to achieve, this will save you some time. So in my case, I set my image duration preferences to 7 seconds. Now let's go back to our project, and I'm going to select all of these photos by hitting Command A on my keyboard, and now I'm going to drag them all here into my timeline. To apply the Ken Burns effect to my first photo, we're going to click on the clip so that it's selected. Next, we're going to go over here to where we have the transform option, and we're going to click on the little arrow just barely to the side, and we're going to switch it over to crop. As you can see here, the Ken Burns effect is the third tab here at the bottom. When you initially click into it, you will see two windows, one outlined in green, the other outlined in red. These are your start and end images. You can resize or drag these windows in order to tell the camera how you want it to move. If I may give you a little piece of advice, I think a lot of people who use this effect make the mistake of making the difference between these two boxes too dramatic, unless that's the effect that you're going for. What I'm saying here is a little goes a long way. It's a little bit like adding spice to a dish. You want to use it to enhance your entree, not steal the attention, or make everyone vomit. If you'd like to quickly swap the start and end frame, just click this button here at the top left of the window. The speed at which it takes the camera to move from the start image to the end image is going to be based on how long the shot is. So if you find the movement is too fast, you can always extend the length of your clip to slow it down, or to speed it up, just shorten the clip. Another tip that I wanted to mention for those of you who are looking to use this effect on videos that you may make in the future is that when you're out and about shooting photos, when you're out with friends or traveling on vacation, in addition to taking photos, I recommend that you also take little videos, and preferably in landscape mode, so sideways. Even if they're just a few seconds long, when you sprinkle these types of videos across your project, it breaks it up so that you have something other than the same type of shot over and over again. By the way, if you want to see an instant preview of the animation that you've just created, just click this little play button here at the top left. In order to stop that preview, tap the space bar. Now that you know the basics of the Ken Burns effect, let's dive in a little bit deeper, and let's have a little bit of fun too. For this example, I'm going to use this photo from my youth. Yes, that's me at age 14 on the right, my sister below me, and the woman to the left is Leah Adler, also known as Steven Spielberg's mother. And if you're wondering what exactly is happening in this photo, I had just asked if we could take a silly photo where we all pretended to look up and scream at a giant T-Rex that was about to eat us. Pay no attention to the fact that we are standing in a Jewish dairy restaurant. By the way, a little fun fact about T-Rexes, their three favorite things to eat are apparently humans, other dinosaurs, and blintzes. Let's say I want to add multiple camera movements to have this zoom into each person's face, pausing on each of those faces for just a moment, and then quickly pulling back to my establishing shot. To accomplish this type of shot, we are going to combine a simple copy and paste formula along with the freeze frame feature. Even though this shot is going to start without any movement, the order of operations is we need to first introduce the Ken Burns effect, and what we will ultimately do is freeze the first frame of that shot in order to create that moment of pause at the beginning. So let's first apply the Ken Burns effect and have it quickly zoom here into Leah's face. I'll make it so that the start image is all of us and the end image is an extreme close-up. In order to get that moment of stillness at the beginning, I can click on this clip so that it's highlighted, and now I can tap the up arrow on my keyboard. That will bring us to the very beginning of that clip. From here, all we need to do is add a freeze frame, which you can use by hitting Option and the letter F. I'm going to retime a lot of these shots just to make sure that the camera movements happen quickly. Because we want the camera to stay on Leah for a second before moving on to my sister, we now need to create another freeze frame at the end part of this shot. So now, let's tap the down arrow to move to the end, and because it's the last frame, we actually need to indent by one frame. So to do that, just tap the left arrow on your keyboard. Now, we can create another freeze frame by once again hitting Option and the letter F. The next movement is going to take us from Leah's extreme close-up to the same shot on my sister Melanie. The camera movement has to match the last shot. So to make that happen, what we need to do is go back and copy the last shot where we use the Ken Burns effect. And once again, using my arrows, let's hit the down arrow to make sure that we're at the very, very end of this sequence. And now let's paste it. The next step is to now reverse these shots. Because when you think about it, the end image from our shot before is now the starting image of this next animation. So just click the button here at the top left to reverse those shots. Now we can reposition the end image so that we're hovered over my sister. From here, once again, we need to create another freeze frame. So let's jump to the end of that shot by pressing the down arrow on your keyboard, then indent by clicking the left key, freeze frame by hitting Option and the letter F, and now I'll repeat those same steps for myself. Finally, I'll freeze frame at the end and throw in some sort of a creative transition. After adding a little creative audio, here's what the end shot ended up looking like. Apologies to Steven Spielberg. Finally, before we go, if you want to take your editing skills to the next level, I encourage you to check out my 2018 class all about Final Cut Pro. That is until I create a 2019 version. And also keep in mind, if you ever need help with editing, that is one of the things I do. You can take a private lesson with me. You can book right through my website at techtalkamerica.com/private lessons. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Happy editing, and I'll see you next time. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.